Remember this? 15 seeders, 200 farmers and 1,300 hits on GRDC's YouTube. As part of GRDC's stubble initiative, Southern Farming Systems held a demo trial in June 2015, giving local growers a unique opportunity to see a wide range of seeders in action in one place.
I think the biggest surprise was the variability in each of the seeders. We were seeing 40 or 50 millimetres difference in where the seed was placed.
And that was one of the real draw cards for growers, to be able to look at the subtle differences between the machines, even though they were broadly categorised into disc or tine setups.
There's some rules of thumb with your disc seeders, basically. They won't handle as wetter conditions. So if it gets wet, sometimes you have to sit back and wait. They will handle stubble a lot better than your tine seeders. And generally, overall, they're a bit more accurate with their seed placement.
However, if we look just 60 kilometres west to Bradvale, where heavy clay soils are common, a similar but replicated trial showed that in order to get good seed placement, the machine must first get through the hard clay pan.
The difference between tine and the disc systems at Bradvale was the ability to be able to cultivate below the seed to create that fine tilth underneath where the seed lay in the seed bed. The other difference in the heavy clay was the disc didn't really open up the seed bed like the tine machine did, so it actually resulted in sort of anaerobic conditions.
So much so that there was a 15% difference in yield between the top and bottom performers, with deep ripping machines coming out on top. And if we stay on yield and look back at the SFS trial, the record dry spring didn't help the results.
Well, normal season, like, you know, we'd be looking at 5 to 6 tonne in our barley here, and, you know, we didn't get anywhere near that this year. Any of the seeders who had high dry matter levels early in the season basically suffered a yield penalty later on in the season.
And in this trial, where conditions were tough, it has really highlighted those aspects that growers may not always pay enough time to, like accurate machine setup.
On the day, the guys that spent more time setting their machine up, I think, had better results. And it just showed how important it is to keep tweaking your machine all the way through the year for the different scenarios that'll pop up.
And with grower groups like SFS keen to keep on top of the important issues, expert advice on seeder setup may be something the group will explore for future events. But for now, the results from the seeder trial have given local growers a lot to think about.
At the end of the day, it's about having the right system for your own soil type, and knowing what works best in your systems.
And having generated so much local interest, a trial like this one has reinforced the need for growers to actually see how other growers are working their systems, question what implements they are using, and why. For the full table of results, visit the SFS website.